today. This is
Isso.
the day that the
The
Lord
Lord
has
has
made,
made,
and we
we
will
will
rejoice
rejoice
and
and
be
be
glad
glad
in
in
it.
it.
Because the joy of the Lord is our
Strength.
strength. I'm Avril.
And I'm Isaac.
We are so glad to be back with more good news from the Bible. You see, we're going to talk about the messianic prophecies and fulfillments in the Old Testament and also in the New Testament, of which Jesus came to fulfill. You know, we believe in the scripture that says that when Jesus says that he didn't come to abolish or make way of the word of God, but he came to fulfill it. Every
Amen.
Bible prophecy,
Yes.
every prophecy in the Bible, he came to fulfill from the
Amen.
beginning till the end. That's why he's called the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And he is a true Messiah.
Amen.
We want to talk about his, you know, the Messiah that was to be born in Bethlehem. That is in Micah 5:2. My husband is just going to read it, and we are so thankful. But before he's going to read it, he's just going to pray and say thank you for the Lord that we can read his word to you, to the listeners. We are glad that you tune in tonight and that you listen this day. And we are glad that you tune in today.
Amen. Father, we just thank you as we come before you and we share your word, Father God. Lord, that it will find a resting place in the hearts of the hearers, Father, and that your word will also fulfill that which it was sent for, Father God, to turn the hearts of people back to you, Father God, to
Yes.
believe in the finished work of the Messiah. And we thank you that as we share about the Messiah that was prophesied, Father God,
Yes.
that people's faith will grow in him, Father. We pray this in Jesus' mighty name.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay, you may start.
Okay, Micah 5, verse 2 says, "But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of you shall come forth to me the one to be ruler in Israel, whose goings forth are from of old, from everlasting."
And what can you explain to the people out there, the listeners out there, concerning this? You know, that, I mean, Ephrata,
Ephrathah.
yeah.
Well, this is a prophecy of where Christ was going to be born in Bethlehem, and it says here that it was Bethlehem is the smallest of all the places in Judah, but as we see in the Word of God itself says he takes the lowly to shame the wise, and here he took the least town in Judah to bring forth the Messiah. And he says here he will be the ruler of Israel, whose going forth are from of old, from everlasting, which means that even as the word declares that before the foundation of the earth, Christ was prepared to come and die for us, to be born for us, to be born in Bethlehem, and to be
Yes.
and to die for us. So he says here he's coming forth, he's from of old. And we see that the Old Testament prophesied what is happening, what we call the New Testament, to make sure that every word of God that he spoke in the Old Testament, every word, every prophetic word has to come to pass, because when God speaks something, it will definitely come to pass.
Amen. That is so
Amen.
true. And here I see in Matthew 2, it says here Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem. What do you
Amen.
explain now? In the land of Judea, during the time when Herod was king, soon afterward, some men who studied the stars came from the east to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is a baby born to be the king of the Jews?" We saw his star when it came up in the east, and we have come to worship him. So God is a God of all nations. You work through this people. And the, you know, they were, it's almost like scientists today, right? People that studying the stars, the moon and
Yes.
all that. So we know that God is the creator of all those things. And God is a creator of all nations as well. And he has put in this people, you know, in this people's heart to go and look for the Messiah. And they found the Messiah and they brought him, they came to worship him by bringing him gifts. And they had given him gifts. And
Yes.
They went via the king there. And when King Herod, the king, he was king of Israel in that time, heard about this, he was very upset.
Yes.
And so was everyone else in Jerusalem, because they couldn't, you know, understand that it was prophesied many years ago by Micah, the prophet Micah. And I mean, he mentioned about these things. He told, as my husband has said, and he called, this is what the King Herod has done. When King Herod heard about this, he was very upset, and so was everyone else in Jerusalem. That means the people that I will say the disbelievers, the unbelievers, sorry. They had disbelief in their heart, and they were unbelievers. They didn't believe the word of God. You see, it is written in the Torah. The Micah was a book of one of the prophets that has come to fulfillment. And God had to use other people from the east to come and tell King Herod about it. And he called together the chief priests. This is what I'm reading still from,
yes,
from Matthew 2. He called together all the chief priests and the teachers of the law and asked them, where will the Messiah be born? In the town of Bethlehem in Judea? They answered, this is what the prophet wrote, Bethlehem in the land of Judah, you are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah. For from you will come a leader who will guide my people Israel.
Amen.
Jesus wasn't just a leader. He was the King of Kings. He was a true Messiah. He came from heaven to earth. God
Yes.
had to come down, as it explained also in the book of John 1. In the beginning was a word, and the word was with God. And the word is God. Understand? And it's alive. It was spoken that time in the beginning when God created the heavens and the earth. He spoke the word into, you know, when his spirit was hovering in the beginning. It says there, Genesis 1, where he said that when God came and his spirit hovered over the darkness, and he spoke light into
yes,
the darkness.
Amen.
And he had to send his only begotten son, Christ Jesus, the true Messiah. Jesus was with him from the beginning
yes,
already.
Amen.
And many people don't understand, but tonight we're not gonna today we're not gonna explain that. We're gonna rather talk about the is soon coming, because the Messiah, we're living in the year 2020, and we are now, according our calendar, the normal calendar,
Gregorian calendar.
Gregorian calendar, yeah, because the right calendar is a Jewish calendar, am I right? Yeah, because their calendar is according the. We know that Jesus is coming soon, but we're not going to work out on calendars and all that, because his coming is very soon. The Messiah
Amen.
Is going to come.
Yes.
And he was born as we are talking to you
Amen.
Tonight. I hope you listeners find this very interesting, because people were trying to even King Herod, he was a king that was so in his sinfulness that he wanted to kill the Messiah, but he couldn't, because God warned the parents, Mary
yes.
and Joseph, and they had to flee to Egypt
yes.
because of this that he wants to
yes.
do. And I want to say that this is what Herod has done in verse 7. He said, so Herod called the visitors from the east to a secret meeting and found out from them the exact time and star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem with these instructions: go and make a careful search for the child. And when you find him, let me know, so that I may go and worship him too. Now that wasn't true, because in his heart he already had plans, and he wanted to wipe out the Messiah. He wanted to kill the Messiah, and he killed many other babies because of this.
Yes.
As you know, this what it says here, after Jesus' birth and all that, he killed many. And so Joseph and Mary had to flee to Egypt when the angel of God came to warn them that they have to flee to Egypt. And you see, Herod was inspired by Satan, because Satan is a killer, as the Word of God says. In the book of John 10:10, it says there that he first robs you away from your eternal inheritance in Christ.
Yeah.
Then he kills you, then he destroys you. And then he doesn't want you to function, and to not just function, but also to follow the true Messiah, that is Christ Jesus. And I want to say to you tonight, the Bible always speaks the truth. The Messiah was chosen by God.
Yes, amen.
You see, and we need to listen to what the Spirit of God is saying.
Amen.
God is holy, and He's a spirit. As I said in the beginning, His Spirit, the Holy Spirit of God, was hovering over the emptiness of this planet Earth. And He had to speak life. He had to speak light first. And then that is why there's day time, there's night time, there's morning time. Morning time, day time, and then night time. So He had to how can I say, separate the day from the night.
Yes.
The light from the night. And today we are the light of, light bearers of Christ. And we cannot hide the light of Christ Jesus. We need to talk about the true Messiah. My husband and I told the Lord, whatever you say, we must preach. Whatever you say, we must teach. Whatever you say that we must witness and talk about your living word, we'll do. And we're just being obedient to His Spirit tonight.
Amen.
And we are thankful
Thank you,
for
Lord
your true
Jesus.
Listeners tonight.
Yes,
the listeners tonight, and listen to His true word. His word is yea and amen.
Yes.
So the Messiah was born. He's real. He is he was chosen by God. As my husband's going to read Deuteronomy 18 verse 19, and then also John 7.
Deuteronomy
18
verse 19, he says, I will raise up for them a prophet like you from among their brethren, and will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak to them all that I command him. Yes, here we can see that this is God speaking to Moses.
Yes.
It says He will raise in the last days, He will raise up a prophet like Moses to His brethren. And He says He will speak what God commands Him. And we find that in the New Testament, where Christ says to the people that I only speak what I hear my Father speak, and I only do what I see my Father do. So we see once again that the Word of God comes through thousands of years after God spoke this to Moses. It came through in the time of Herod, which Avril just read now about the birth of Christ. And that is what God is promising Moses here. And it came to pass in the time of Herod, even where Christ had to flee to Egypt, where his parents Mary and Joseph took him to stay until Herod died.
Yes, that is so true. So we're gonna read the about the Messiah, what Jesus has said, what he went through, that he was really chosen by God. You know, he's
Amen.
Anointed, the anointed and appointed Messiah.
Amen.
By God, Father God, our God, He's God and our God.
Mm.
He's Father and our Father, that, you know, that who art in heaven. And we are so glad that we can talk about that. Let us just read from verse, let me just see. We are here in chapter 7 of John. You see, this is about Jesus and his brothers. They ask him many questions. And after this, Jesus traveled to Galilee. He did not want to travel in Judea because the Jewish authorities there was wanting to kill him. You see, at his birth, King Herod tried to kill him. But it wasn't his time because he had to come to bring everything. He had to be born as a Messiah. He had to come as the only true Messiah to bring the message of salvation and the message of the Holy Spirit. Because John was the one that prepared. He said this, I'm only preparing the way for the true King of Kings and the true Messiah. And he and Jesus came to him and he said, behold, this man is the one that God has chosen. He even said to John in chapter 1 of John, chapter 1 of John, where John spoke and said that this is a Messiah.
Amen.
There's no other way. John said it, and it's even, and his own brothers were like trying, you know, to still find out, is this true? Because this is now, I think Jesus was in the early 30s or late 20s when this happened. I'm not so sure. But to come back, I want to say, is like the Jewish Feast of Tabernacles was near. So Jesus' brother said to him, leave this place and go to Judea so that your disciples will see the works you are doing. You see, and no one hides what he is doing if he wants to be well known. Since you are doing these things, let the whole world know about you. Not even his brothers believed in him. You know, that is so true. His own brothers didn't even believe in him while he was alive, while he lived among them, while he grew up with them. He's an elder brother of them. And they didn't recognize him as a Messiah. But his own dad knew it, Joseph, that he was born we call it the seed, the holy seed that God has planted into Mary's womb. Mary was a virgin when that happened, and she was ready when Gabriel came and told her that she's gonna have a baby called Emmanuel, God with us. And of course they called him Yeshua, I think so in Hebrew, and then we in English it's called Jesus, in Afrikaans, we are Afrikaans speaking, it's called Jesus. And Jesus Christus, and he is Jesus Christ, the
Amen.
True Messiah.
Amen.
He is Jesus Christus,
yes.
Die ware Messiah. And we can just say to you tonight, even in that time, they were while he was ministering the word, the true word, because he was a living word, they tried to kill him as well.
Yes.
And he was always confronted by many religious people at that time.
Yes.
So no one, this is what they say. Sorry, let me say. So Jesus said to them, the right time for me has not yet come. He always told them that. And they didn't understand him. Am I right here? So any time is right for you. The world cannot hate you, but it hates me because I keep telling it that its ways are bad. Because Herod has bad ways. He rejected the Messiah. And he rejected him also as a King of Kings. Because he didn't understand what was prophesied came to fulfillment. Amen?
Amen.
So we are rejoicing
Amen.
About the true Messiah.
Amen.
The soon coming Messiah. The true Messiah that is still going to come. Hallelujah. That is going to come. The soon coming Messiah. As a King of Kings and Lord of all.
Amen.
Yes. So the right time for me has not yet come, as Jesus said. So you go on to the feast. I am not going to this feast because the right time has not come for me. He said this and then stayed on in Galilee. So Jesus was always confronted by his own family, his own brothers that he lived with. But obviously he was concerned about them, but he wasn't much bothered by it. He just kept on being the obedient, anointed Messiah, and how can I say, the King of Kings, you know, that God has
Amen.
chosen, because
Yes.
he is anointed. Christ means the anointed
That one,
one.
yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So after his brothers went to the feast, Jesus also went. However, he did not go openly, but went secretly. There was much whispering about him in the crowd. He is a good man. Some people said no. Others said he fools the people. But no one talked about him openly because they were afraid of the Jewish authorities. Because the Jewish authorities, you know, those that was in the Sanhedrin, and that
Yes.
they were the religious leaders, and they were the ones that was giving Jesus a very, very hard time. And but Jesus always rebuked when it was necessary to rebuke, because he knew he was the only true Son of God. There was no other way that they could believe that he's a true Messiah, because they only believed he was a prophet like the prophets of old, and they were speaking about Jesus. Even in Isaiah 53, which is still forbidden for many religious leaders in Israel, the Orthodox Jews. Am I right here?
Yes,
Yeah.
amen.
So the feast was nearly half over when Jesus went to the temple and began teaching. Because that was a place that you go, because that was the gathering of all the Jewish leaders. And they listened to him. They heard him speaking about great things. So the Jewish authorities, greatly surprised, said, "How does this man know so much when he was never been to school?" You see, all those things that they ask about Jesus. So Jesus answered, "What I teach is not my teaching, but comes from God, amen, who
Amen.
sent me. Whoever is willing to do what God wants, we will know whether what I teach comes from God, or whether I speak on my own authority." A person who speaks on his own is trying to gain glory for himself. You see, Jesus, he always gave the Father the glory. All glory to the Father, our Heavenly Father. He never took the glory, because all glory belongs to him as well, as a true Messiah.
Amen.
And we know that today. He's a glorious, soon coming Messiah. And this is what the message is about. He's alive and he is coming soon.
Yes.
Amen. So
Amen.
we're looking forward for that. And his teaching was so wonderful, and that, and they couldn't believe that, you know, Jesus never went to school. He never went there, because he was God in flesh, the Son of God in flesh. And they couldn't understand who he really was. Okay, so yeah, it says, whoever is willing to do what God wants will know whether what I teach comes from God, or whether I speak on my
My
own
own,
authority.
yes.
A person who speaks on his own, trying to gain glory for himself. He who wants glory for the one who sent him, however, is honest, and there is nothing false in him. And Moses gave you the law, he said. Did he not? But not one of you obeys his law. Why are you not obeying the law? Why are you trying to kill me? He asked. The crowd answered, "You have a demon in you." Jesus answered, "I did one great work, and you were all surprised, because Moses ordered you to circumcise your sons, although it was not Moses but your ancestors who started it. You will circumcise a boy on the Sabbath. If a boy is circumcised on the Sabbath, so that Moses' law will not be broken, why are you angry with me? Because I made a man completely well on the Sabbath? Stop judging by external standards and judge by true standards."
Amen.
Because everything about the kingdom of God is true standards. Heavenly things that Jesus speak, the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of God, is all truthful. Jesus
Amen.
is the way, the truth, and the everlasting life.
Yes,
They ask
amen.
him that. And he said, I am the way. Jesus said it, the truth and the everlasting life. That's why when he said to the people, when he spoke to them in the Sanhedrin and that, you know, about the at the Feast of Tabernacles, he was telling them, stop judging by eternal standards and judge by the true standards. You see, we need to stand on the biblical standards, what Jesus, everything written in red in the Bible, what Jesus said, from the beginning till the end. Because Jesus and the Father are one. You cannot separate them.
Yes.
You know, if you speak about Jesus, you speak about this, you talk about our Father. Because they are one. And then the Holy Spirit, of course, that is with us here on earth.
Amen.
If you are, you can never tell lies when the Holy Spirit is, when you're empowered by the Holy Spirit. When you are filled with the Holy Spirit. And Jesus was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He was full of the power of the Holy Spirit. That's
Amen.
Why John recognized it. John saw it. He baptized people with water, but he said, there's one coming after me that's going to baptize you in the fire power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus was full of the power of the Holy Spirit. That's why he could drive out demons. And that's why they're trying to call him, you know, that he's got a demon in him because he drive out other demons. How can they be so ignorant by saying things like that? And today there's people that are following lies. They're following the father of lies, which is Satan. They are inspired by Satan because they're coming from different religious background. And when you cannot talk about Jesus about the Holy Spirit when you're not saved. You cannot.
Amen.
Only when you're born again, blood was child of God, like myself and my husband and our children and families are. And, you know, if you are a child of God, you will agree with me tonight.
Amen.
That you can speak only the truth by His Spirit, that is Jesus' Spirit.
Amen.
Because He lived, because John recognized it. John that baptized people in water, and He baptized Jesus as well, because Jesus said He comes to fulfill the things, all the fulfillments that has been spoken. He was setting the example to all of us.
Yes.
My husband and I was also baptized in the water and also by the fire of God, the holy baptism of God. You know, we call it the holy baptism, the firepower of God. And we are glad tonight because it is all about Jesus.
Amen.
It's all about His firepower. It's all about His Holy Spirit that He has given us, that He has sent us on the day of Pentecost. You know, they were having a feast there in the upper room there in the disciples, where they came together after Jesus' resurrection. And Jesus spent 40 days with them in His resurrected body. You
Amen.
Know, we call it His glorious body. He was spending quality time with them, saying to them about our future. As it tells us, I'm almost at the end, because we got, this is the first time that we spoke about this, about the Messiah. I spoke about it two years ago concerning the Messiah, the fulfillment of the Messiah. The Messiah that we just spoke about was to be born in Bethlehem, that we read in Micah 5:2, and the Messiah was chosen by God in John 7. And then some of the people of Jerusalem said, isn't this the man they are trying to kill? Look, he is talking in public, and nobody says anything against him. Can it be that the authorities really know that he is a Messiah? But when the Messiah comes, no one will know where he is from. And we all know where this man comes from. As Jesus taught in the temple, he said in a loud voice, Do you really know me and know where I'm from? But I have not come on my own. He who sent me, however, is true.
Amen.
That is God the Father. You do not know him, but
Amen.
I know him, because I know him and he sent me. Then they tried to arrest him, but no one laid a hand on him, because his hour had not yet come.
Amen.
But many in the crowd believed in him. That is so awesome.
Amen.
They believed because they heard him spoke about the you know, about our future and about who he really is and about sorry, and about God the Father, that, you know, and about the fulfillments of the Bible fulfillments, the messianic prophecies, let me rather say it that way. It's all the messianic prophecies that from Isaiah right to Malachi, they all spoke about the same thing, that about the true Messiah that
Amen.
Has come to fulfill all the prophecies in the Bible.
Amen.
Even what as my husband read about Moses as well.
Amen.
Moses had wrote the first five the five books in the Bible in the Old Testament. We are so glad that we could share this to you tonight.
Amen.
And with that, we greet you and thank you for all the listeners. We will come back with more great news about the true Messiah.
Amen.